let us take next set of questions. Okay, you can start attempting these. I'll put one more. Did we do this? And this one, the earlier one? No. Do that. Oh, that is the reason why we didn't do it. Okay. Both of them complete. So this is option 2, right?
Yes.
Right. Next one. I think this is straightforward, just, you know, you should know it. 18th. Why the electrical conductivity of semiconductor increase because of the radiation? No, let's talk about the valence and conduction band related to that. Because electrons from the valence band, they can jump, right? Because only conduction electrons are responsible for conductivity, right? So you need energy corresponding to this wavelength for them to jump. This is like minimum energy required for them to jump. Okay. This is like valence band and this is conduction band. Okay. So energy corresponding to this can be absorbed by the valence shell, valence band electron, and this electron may jump to conduction band. Okay. How much energy is required is actually equal to the band gap. Right? Band gap by definition is the minimum energy difference between conduction and valence band. This is Eg. How much is this? Quickly.
Option
3. 0.5? Okay, so see, this is how you solve it. Don't need to do that. Hc by E lambda, right? This is energy in terms of electron volt. Okay. H is 6.6 into 10 raised to the power minus 30. See, why I'm showing you how to calculate, because this will come again and again. Okay. This type of calculation, this divided by 1.6 into 10 raised to the power minus 19, wavelength is what? 2.48 into 10 raised to the power minus 6, right? Now you can see that this is almost 4 times. So 6.6 divided by 1.6 is like frequently it will be coming. So this is near 4. Slightly more than 4. So just remember that it is slightly more than 4. Okay. And 6 plus 19 is?
25
plus 8? 33. So you just cancel all of this. I just put 10 raised to the power minus 1. Okay. Now see, it become 12 divided by 2.48, which is like what? 12 divided by 2.5, right? 12 divided by 2.5. 2.5 is what? Around 5 by 2. Okay, this into 10 to the minus 1. Now this is 5 to the 10, 2.4. So around it is coming 0.48, right? So like this you can roughly estimate the value. So don't get overwhelmed by so much calculation. You can easily handle, right? That is our option number 3 is correct. Y divided by E? Electron volts. Fine. Next question. This we have done. This one. Solve this one, all of you. Any other answer? Option B. Where is B? Second one. Okay. Now, first tell me which one of them is more stable. This one or that one? This one is more stable? Why? What? Give me some logic. Why do you think? I'm asking you which one of these two nucleus is more stable. Okay. Do you have any logic that, okay, this is more stable because of this? Whatever you have learned, don't create a logic. Okay. Whatever you have learned based on that, tell me which one of them is more stable. Copper 30. Why? What? See, there lies the problem. See, here you are looking at the electronic configuration, okay? But we are talking about nucleus here. Chemically, it will be more stable, but I am talking about stability of nucleus, not the electrons, okay? So which nucleus is more stable? Because all the decays, they happen for the nucleus, not for the electrons. Second one is more stable. Why?
Because the mass is lesser, meaning this energy from energy, mass energy.
Exactly. So, see what happens in both the cases, 64 protons or neutrons, okay, 64 of them, they combine to produce either 29 copper 64 or they produce 30 copper 64. Okay, now mass of this is lesser, mass of these 64 proton and neutron, it is same, both the cases, okay. So the mass difference between this and that is more. So more mass is converted into energy. Are you getting it? So that is the reason why this is more stable. Because its actual mass is lesser. So more mass would have got converted into energy and That is why it is more stable. Alright, so you can say that it is like both are exothermic reaction and more heat is released in the second reaction, like that you can understand. Okay, so now if there is a decay, who will decay? The lesser stable one. Who is lesser stable? Copper 29, right? So one more thing, one of them is copper and another one is zinc, because both of them can't have 29 atomic number. So let me just check which one of them. Yeah, but the element is different. Whose atom zinc atomic number do you know? Zinc is 30. Copper 29. So this is zinc. This is not copper. This is zinc. Okay. So copper will decay. Zinc will not decay. Right. So this is out of question. And if it is a gamma decay, then atomic number will not get affected. Right. Here atomic number is getting affected. So even this is not true. So this is most suitable answer. Getting it? Because zinc is more stable, right? It's a natural tendency that you go from lesser stable to more stable one. Okay? What you're talking about?
If it was Cu64.
Cu30 doesn't exist. 30 atomic number is zinc. Printing error. What? Cu20, sorry, zinc 30 is more stable. Cu30, there is nothing called Cu30. It was a printing error. Okay. So zinc 30 is more stable. So copper will decay into more stable form, zinc. Start solving the question. Do you remember question number last one? Solve these two questions. Twentieth is fourth. See, for hydrogen, energy in nth orbit is -13.6 by n square. For hydrogen like atom, energy in nth orbit is 13.6 by n square into z. What is z?
Atomic
number. Okay. So energy required to remove electron from ground state of doubly ionized helium is what? How will go about it, I'm asking?
1 by n square minus n square.
What is nf?
nf is infinity.
NF is infinity, right? Right? So energy, when energy of an electron, when it leaves the nucleus, when it has just sufficient amount of energy, its potential energy will anyway become zero. It goes to infinity, right? And minimum energy required will be such that even its kinetic energy becomes zero. Okay. So energy of the lithium atom's first electron will be what? 13.6. Sorry, lithium atom's electron, which is in ground state, is 1 square into 9. 3 square is 9. So this much electron volt is its energy, which is negative. And if I want to make its energy zero, what should I do? Have to do this much energy, I have to supply, so that total energy becomes zero. No, that is not ionized. Ionized means the electron leaves and goes away. That means it goes to infinity. Yeah, of course, why not? Kirchhoff's loop rule is valid anywhere. We have solved alternating current questions also. Kirchhoff's loop rule and junction rule, they are just conservation of charge, and one point cannot have two potential. B. Where is B? 2. Second option? Isn't this something which is straight? How much current will flow in this loop?
Zero.
Zero. So this is, you just throw it away, this one. Including resistance, you throw it away. The current is flowing simply like this, all the currents. Okay. It will be as if 150 plus 100 are in series. Okay. So the current will be what? Tell me. This is 6 volt.
Power resistance.
What?
There's 50 ohms of power resistance. The
yes. Tell me, how will you get current is equal to what? Tell me, how will you write 6 divided by 100 plus 150 plus 50. Okay. Now, here there is a small assumption. The assumption is the forward bias doesn't offer any backward voltage, but there is a small 0.7 volt. All right, so actually you should write 6 minus 0.7 divided by all this, but we are ignoring that. Fine, so just be aware of that. So this is 6 divided by 300. How much is this? 0.02. All of you understood this? Should I move to next one? These two. Black background is better, right? Option 2. Yes, this also is 23rd. First one. There you go. I mean, see, first of all, respect the question. H mu minus, at least you should write this formula. At least. Okay. So, stopping potential is asked. So, this is K max, right? Which can be written as E into V. V is stopping potential. So, stopping potential is what? H mu minus phi divided by E. So maximum kinetic energy of photoelectron emitted from a surface is 4 electron volts. So basically E into V itself is given 4 electron volts. So V will come out to be 4 volts. Right? So option number 2 is correct over here. But at least write something. Don't just run over it unless you have seen similar question already. Okay, because chances are high that there will be a small trick hidden, which you, if you skip the steps, you lose the trick and you not earn zero, right? You know that. You get minus one. Start doing this question. I'll upload the other one. You can see many theoretical questions are asked. What is the answer? Correct. So it's a probabilistic event. We cannot be definitive about it. It may or may not decay. 25th. Okay, for this, you can actually draw a PN junction first. Talking about 25. This is the junction. This is P, this is N. Okay. Now, see, here you need to evaluate the options. Okay. Here you need to evaluate the options. Okay. So, you cannot just ignore all the options. So, you can't just solve this and get the correct answer, right? You have to check which of the options make sense. So, you need to read actually all of it. So, probably all the options are talking about just electric field. So, you need to just look at the electric field. But some options talk about electric field, some talk about potential. Okay. Now, if I know that only single option is correct, I'll first look at the easiest of all, which is what? Finding the electric field okay, right now because I have drawn that. So we have electric field like this, any doubt here? Right, so electric field should be from N to P, right? So option 3 is correct. So if it is a single option correct, I'll just move ahead, okay? Otherwise, if I have to look at the potential also, then which will have higher potential? N has higher potential, right? Positively charged, slightly higher potential, okay? But there is no current, why? Okay. There is no closed circuit, okay? It's like a battery, you're keeping battery, 5 volt battery, but then voltage is there, current is not there. Fine, let's move to next one. Have you seen that X-ray video which I have given? Solve this. This 26. Every time there is power failure. Frequently they ask questions on X-rays, so it is for your benefit to watch that video which I have seen. 26, first telling that. How many of you have seen that video?
I haven't seen that, but I studied 2 times.
Okay. Okay, 26th is 2. Okay, so we have for X-ray graph like this, right? Those who have seen it can relate. It starts from this minimum wavelength and it goes on. This is like intensity of the radiation. For different wavelengths it comes out. These two are characteristic X-rays, K alpha, K beta, characteristic wavelength. Now once you watch that video, you will understand it, okay? Anyways, 27th, anybody did?
Three.
Yeah. The work function of a substance is 4, the longest wavelength of light that can cause photoelectric emission. That's, I think, straightforward. All you have to do is, you know that work function is this much, so at least you need this much energy, so at least this much frequency. So minimum frequency is largest wavelength, right? So just equate hc by e lambda with 4, okay? From here you will get lambda to be equal to hc by 4e, okay? Which will come out to be, see, you know, when you divide charge of electron with H, factor of 4 comes, then divide by 4 also. So I think it should be around speed of light into some 10 raised power something. So 3 should be there. So that's how you can arrive.
So H by E will give some factor of
4. H by E will give you first digit as 4. And 4 by 4, around 1. Yeah, 4 exactly 1. And then speed of light, this it has 3 in it, okay? But don't use these kind of things if you are not very, if you have not done a lot of practice. Don't force yourself to do like this. Be honest with yourself, otherwise you'll make a lot of silly errors. 20. Okay. Now let's see. Let's first look at these. Let's first look at these four nuclei. Okay. Which one of them is most stable? Y is most stable, right? So if lesser stable one becomes more stable, it will be a spontaneous process and it will release the energy also. I mean, it will not be spontaneous, maybe there is activation energy, but then yeah, it will release energy ultimately because lesser stable to more stable, right? Now look at the first one. Y is giving 2z. Y is more stable, 2z, it will absorb energy. Okay, look at the second. W is giving x plus z. Now x is more stable but z is less stable, so you can't be sure about it. Okay, look at the third one. W giving 2y. Now this is sure shot. When W gives 2y, definitely it is going to be more stable. Okay, and you'll have option number 3 to be correct.
So,
the
question says releasing energy. So even 2 can also release energy.
Would release is a definitive statement, it is not saying may release energy. Okay, so let me do one thing. I don't have to scroll too much. There are lots and lots of theoretical questions that have asked in JEE. Twenty-ninth. What is the answer? Online class होती तो फटाक से बता दे. There was this guy, I was taking online class, so he knew which book I refer to. So
yeah, I have a question.
I caught him. So it was question number 7 or 8 in my list, and in that book it was question number 5. So he said 5 option 4 is correct. Wait, let me talk to you. So it's a very, very bad and very you're damaging your prospect, and also you are making everybody else feel that okay, they don't know many things, like how come somebody is suddenly become so intelligent. But actually what happens is that guy was making fool of himself. Okay, so there will be a lot of such cases, so just do your best. Okay, that's all you can do, right? Anyways, so why to be a lot of, there should not be any worry as such. Okay, 29th, which one? See, you should be knowing it as a matter of fact.
How?
If you have read your NCERT book, and if you know that R is equal to R naught a to the power 1 by 3, and the value of R naught, if you remember, then density is independent of the atomic mass or atomic number. It comes of the order of 10 to the power 17. So they expect you to remember this. Okay? Anyways.
For any element, it's independent of the atomic number.
If it is independent, then for any element, it's... It is independent. The nucleus is so tightly packed. You're getting it? I mean, if there are more number of nucleons, more volume will be there. But density is independent. 30th. What is neon's atomic number? 10. It after absorbing energy decays into two alpha particles. So two alpha particle, so it gives this. So what will be this? Suppose this is X. So what will be the atomic number?
6.
So atomic number defines what the element is. Mass number doesn't define. It's carbon. Oh, this is Doppler effect. Question number 30? 31. Yeah, I'll just directly tell you the formula. And anybody knows this? Okay, write down. The formula is delta lambda. There is a derivation also to it. We will not get into that. This is equal to v divided by speed of light. Okay.
What do you mean by h alpha light?
What is?
H alpha light.
It's hydrogen spectrum, right? Alpha is it's one of the wavelength, one of the characteristic wavelength of hydrogen spectrum. Okay, now the same wavelength, same as in the same EM wave, has a different wavelength observed and actual. So you can use this formula directly over here. Lambda naught is the original wavelength. V is the speed with which galaxy is moving away.
So
Then?
It's option B.
B.
Option B.
So, V is speed of light multiplied by difference in the observed wavelength and the actual wavelength is how much? 706 minus 656. Okay? Divided by the actual wavelength. 656. Okay. So when you calculate this, you will get C into what? Numerator is 50. 50 divided by roughly denominator is also 650. Roughly. Okay. And then this is 13. Okay. So basically you're doing 3 into 10 is power 8, or let's say 3 divided by 1.3 into 10 is power 7. So 3 divided by 1.3, so you don't have any problem in the first digit, right? All the options have 2 in it. So it's just a 10 is a power of what it is. It has to be second. Okay. Fine, we'll move to the next one. This one, 32nd.
So second one, option
B.
Yeah,
second?
No, three.
Three.
I'm getting
empty answer. Sai will answer. Doubting the question? How dare you?
Doubting means if it's options.
Huh?
They can
be different. Once you get a question, you solve it or you just SSC
kya kar rahe hain?
All of you try. What is the first step here? Like what is the bottom line which you should use?
Conservation of momentum.
Energy may not, mechanical energy may not be conserved. Some part of it will get lost as heat. So the momentum of the two particles will be equal and opposite, yes or no? Because initial momentum was zero.
Yeah.
Right? So magnitude of momentum of M1 is equal to magnitude of momentum of M2. Let's say that is P. Isn't it? Because sum of the momentum, vector sum should be zero. So magnitude wise they should be same. Okay? So if one goes this way, other will go in opposite way with equal momentum. Any doubt here? No. Now, de Broglie wavelength is what? H by P.
Yeah.
Now, momentum is same. So, wavelength will be same.
Yeah.
So, option 3. No, momentum doesn't depend on mass. Sorry, wavelength doesn't depend on mass. Wavelength depends on momentum.
Yeah.
Multiplication of mass and velocity.
And how is momentum equal to
initial momentum.
देखो, नहीं हम ना बताऊँगा, it is getting recorded ना, see this is total mass m1 and m2, okay, initial momentum m1 and m2 is zero, so when it breaks into m1 and m2, it's like explosion, sort of, okay, so initial momentum of m1 and m2 was zero, it should be zero afterwards also, whatever the force, it is internal between them, there is no external force. That is why momentum of M1 will be equal to momentum of M2. Fine, so let's move to the next one. Let's look at the theoretical questions in this chapter. So at times you think that physics is only numerical, but it's not true. This is 33. 34. 33rd, which one? Option 1?
Yeah.
2, sir.
2.
2.
You're telling me 2?
No,
1. No, Shaimir.
33
is 2. Millionaire coach in the class. Gamma rays are EM waves, okay? They are not particles. This is definitely not correct. They are like highly energetic EM waves. Okay. Then, is alpha particle singly ionized? Doubly ionized? Proton and neutrons have no. Although beta has beta minus and beta plus. Beta minus is cathode, but in general you can say okay, fine. One of the beta rays is cathode ray. 34th. Can I what?
Increase the size.
This is being live on YouTube.
Ask her, she knows. Now it is fine? You took a live on the pool in the mobile. You want to split? Strange the way. Three, half-life period of radioactive element is same as a mean life of other. Initially, both of them have same number of atoms. Three? All of you?
Because at every step it's...
Okay, should I solve it? So T half of X is same as the mean life of Y. Okay. So 0.693 divided by lambda X is equal to 1 by lambda Y. So lambda X is 0.693 times lambda Y. Fine, initially both of them have same number of atoms. Same number of atoms means same number of nucleus also. Okay, so little twist here, what if I tell you that there are two compounds, X and X2, suppose this is X, the first one, and second one is Y, and I say both of them have same number of molecules. Then one molecule of this has two nucleus.
Yeah.
Getting it? So which you write dN by dt is equal to lambda n. N is number of nucleus, not number of compounds. You have to count how many nucleus are there. Fine, so remember all that. Let's do this first. Now, initially both of them have same number of atoms. Then, whose decay rate will be, I mean decay rates will be different? Because lambda is different. Now, decay rate is what? dN by dt is equal to minus lambda times n. Okay, so if it is n, so for x it is lambda x into n, for y it is lambda y into n. Which will be more? Lambda x will be more. See, lambda y is more, right? So y's decay will be faster than x. So that is why option 3. Okay, so lambda y is lambda x divided by 0.693, which is more than lambda x. Lambda x is less than lambda y. Fine. Okay. Simultaneous radioactive. We have covered that in theory already. That x gives y and then y gives z. What? Sir, I'm about to do that. This is what? Question number? 30. Now you will not be able to do this because you haven't gone through that. When you will be sincere with your preparation, when you will start doing that, any plans? See, I think I have briefed a little bit last class. This time again I will tell you that the characteristic X-ray will be created only when electrons from the target element get knocked off. Okay, now do this. And how continuous X-ray gets emitted? The electrons which are coming from outside will get decelerated because of the interaction with the target element's electron and its nucleus. So because of the deceleration, its energy goes down. So difference in energy, a photon gets emitted. That is continuous X-ray. Now, when it is characteristic X-ray, these electrons come from outside, like for example 80 kilovolt, kilo electron volt. That will knock off one electron from the tungsten and then transition from higher shells to from where it has knocked off will happen, and that will release a photon. That is characteristic X-ray. So characteristic X-ray has nothing to do with what was the energy of the electron coming, because the energy gap is between the shells of the tungsten. But that continuous X-ray is because of the energy of the electron that are coming from outside. It is getting slowed down, and because of that, to be comfortable with this, you have to watch that video once.
So,
what is the answer here? You are saying option 1. Any other answer? Acha, will it have a characteristic X-ray or not?
Yeah.
Can it knock off an electron or not? 80 kilo electron volt. It can knock off. There will be a characteristic X-ray.
Option 4.
abhi option 4 ho gaya.
Sir, I didn't know that. Sir, option 1 you see.
There will be a characteristic X-ray, okay? And then how will you find minimum wavelength when all the energy of the electron completely loses its energy, and that energy with which it was coming towards the atom, that gets converted to photon. Okay, so now do that. Let's see whether you get 0.155 minimum wavelength. So that is why there is a minimum wavelength of continuous, because electron when it comes, it will have some energy. Okay, so maximum possible frequency will be emitted when all the energy of the electron gets converted into photon. Simply you have to do hc by approximately that. So you know, whenever this h comes and there is 1.6, you can just cancel out and say it is 4 over there. So you can calculate lambda. So when all the energy of the electron gets converted into photon, that's when you have lambda minimum or maximum frequency. Okay, so option 4 is correct. Okay, how do you find questions on modern physics compared to other chapters? Very easy. But then if you like, you know, take it for granted, if you start taking like, fine, these are like simple chapter, let me do it towards the end, I'll be able to do it. You'll not get these. It's not that easy also that will be just ignore it and you'll towards the end you'll just master it. It can't. But then that's why I'm telling you, your good amount of time should get into or should go into the chapters which are easy and which you think you can master easily. Okay? Stop doing chapters which you have very little idea of. Don't try to learn anything new. Whatever you know, strengthen it. Getting it 60% marks in JEE Mains is very good. Don't run behind those extra 10% marks and then your entire 60-70% marks which you will get, that will suffer. Okay. This is 30. done. Actually, here you should have knowledge. No, you cannot just, I mean, otherwise you need to derive from the scratch. Mv square by r is equal to all that. Okay, so you should have some knowledge of how you write the wavelength. So 1 by lambda is what? Rydberg constant. 1 by n1. Okay. Now your Rydberg constant is proportional to mass. Your Rydberg constant changes depending on which element it is. Because if it is for hydrogen, it is 1. Sorry, Rydberg constant into 1. Now here it is 2 times. So Rydberg instead of Rydberg constant, you write 2 RH. Are you getting it? So like that you have to write. Or you use the fact that energy is proportional to mass. Energy in nth level, which is right, 13.6 by n square. Okay. So this is Rydberg constant into 2. Now, here you have what? Transition from where to where?
First to second.
First excite. First excited levels. First excited level is what? N is equal to 2, and longest possible means from 2 to 3. So 1 by 2 square minus 1 by 3 square. Lambda is shortest for when second goes infinity. Lambda shortest means 1 by lambda is longest. Lambda longest means 1 by lambda is smallest. So 1 by lambda is 2 times Rydberg constant, 1 by 4 minus 1 by 9. So lambda will come out to be 18 by 5. 5 in denominator, R in denominator, right?
Yeah.
So number 3. Okay, so in modern physics, those derivations, you know, in your school book or whatever it is, you are very comfortable with hydrogen atoms. So if someone wants to make a problem which many could not solve, you can't make a very tricky question. So what they do, they make questions based out of whether you know something or not. Okay, so look at the derivation very closely, how it is derived. Then only you'll be able to say that, okay, fine, energy should be proportional to mass also, or how atomic number comes in that. You should know how atomic number comes, or what, I mean, right? So what all those, when you write mv square by r is equal to gm1 m2 by r square, and when you write potential energy, kinetic energy, so get into the details of it, because knowledge is more important in these chapters than your analytical skills. Fine, so let's move to the next one. Any doubts? This 37, right? Thank you. Question 4. Anybody else? Shruti also bummed today.
It's her birthday.
Oh, happy birthday. So she is having party at home. She didn't call you.
She called, but then.
Okay, modern physics is more. So like full day party. Okay, now I'll start solving. So decay constant for x1 is 10 lambda, decay constant for x2 is lambda. They need to find ratio of number of nuclei of x1 to that of x2. So number of nuclei for x1 is 0 e to the power minus lambda 1 t and nx2. Number of nuclei are same initially. So this, now the ratio of number of nuclei is equal to e to the power lambda 2 minus lambda 1 into t. Okay, now it is asking you x1 divided by x2. Okay, so lambda 2 is lambda 1 is 10 lambda. Okay, so this is e to the power minus 9 lambda t. Any doubts? E to the power minus 9 lambda t. You need to find when this will become e to the power minus 1. So t will be equal to 1 by 9 lambda. That's why option 4. Okay, any doubts? Fine, we'll move to the next one. Option 2. Any other answer? Total energy remains same.
It's kinetic energy. Option 3.
Don't tell I taught you this chapter.
Option 3 is not.
See, total energy, total energy is what? Total energy in nth orbit is 13.6 by n square electron volts, right? So total energy will what? When it goes to ground state from excited state, what will happen to total energy? It will decrease, it becomes more negative. So it will decrease. Okay, now what? See, kinetic energy is what? Now look at how kinetic energy is defined. Kinetic energy is what? In terms of total energy is
positive
of total energy and potential energy is what? 2 times of total energy. Getting it? So this will become minus of 27 by 2 by n square electron volt. This is potential energy. Kinetic energy is plus 13.6 by n square electron volts. So when you add it, you'll get total energy. Getting it? Kinetic energy will be positive, it can't be negative. Now, when you're decreasing n from 2 to 1, it goes, right? So its kinetic energy, what happens to it? Kinetic energy increases. Excited state to the ground state. When n becomes 1, kinetic energy is 13.6 electron volt. And earlier it was 13.6 divided by 4 electron volt. So kinetic energy increased. So this is out of, so like that, you know, you can just. Now it is between 1 and 4. So kinetic energy will. 4 is gone. Kinetic energy increases, potential and total energy decreases. Okay, so like, you know, there will be multiple checkpoints when you solve a question. Once you arrive one landmark, this thing, immediately look at the option and remove, start rejecting the options so that you can narrow down to the correct one faster. Okay. And you know, the revolution of electron around the nucleus is very similar to the planetary movements around the sun. So you can imagine, like, you know, Mars being very close to sun, it revolves very fast. Okay, as you move closer to the sun, gravitational force becomes very strong, or the centripetal force becomes very small. Okay, so velocity should be very high to create that acceleration towards the center. I mean, okay, we will move to the next one. August Fekna, throw something else. Good. I'll upload another one. Thirty-nine, which option? The electron that comes out in a beta decay, it is not your outer shell electron. Okay, the neutron becomes proton, and because of charge conservation, electron will first generate inside the nucleus and then it will come out because nucleus is unstable with electron in it. Okay, now 40th. A for apple. You remember I have circulated one message on the group?
Yes, sir.
What was that?
Live in Bahamar.
Bahamar
is.
Bas yehi aa gaya. Bahamar is
visible.
Lyman. Lyman is UV. And Pastion. IR. Bahamar. Okay. Lyman means what? Lyman is transition from or to what?
To any higher.
To one. Right? So option number one. Oh, sorry, infrared. Passion. Lyman, Bahamar, Passion. Three. No. Lyman, Bahamar,
passion.
It's a minor power pass. It's a passion.
But
it's
Oh guys, this is for hydrogen like atom. This is not for hydrogen atom. So this is for hydrogen atom. Okay, for hydrogen like atom, transition from n equal to 4 to 3 results in
UV.
Okay, so let's say 1 by lambda is Rydberg constant into z square from 1 by 3 square minus 1 by 4 square. Okay, this results in UV, and UV should be Lyman, right? So here it should be 1 by 1 square should come, so z becomes 3. Okay, so like that you can, you know, roughly figure out. Now z becomes 3, so now what you should get? Infrared.
So why is z 3 again?
This is UV series, 1 by 1 square minus 1 by n square, right? So if you correlate, z should be 3. Okay, now I should get what? Infrared. Infrared is what? 1 by RH, 1 by, infrared is Lyman-Balmer-Paschen, 3, right? 1 by 3 square minus 1 by whatever, n square. Okay, so you're the first one should be 1 by 3 square, it should come, right? We know that 3 square is anyway outside. Okay, so if 3 square has to come outside, then it would be 3 into 3, right? See, 2 to 1 is anyway out of question, because it will be higher frequency. 3 to 2 is also higher frequency. Okay, even 4 to 2 is even higher frequency. Right? The only option left is 4. So like that you can just arrive at the final answer by rejecting it. Okay. Again, X-ray. But I think we have discussed enough for you to answer this question. 41. This is lambda k, characteristic wavelength. No, wait, intensity of X-ray, Coolidge tube. Minimum obtained is lambda c, variant of k alpha is lambda k. So this, you know, k alpha is just characteristic wavelength. One of the characteristic wavelength as k alpha. The first one, in fact, is k alpha. Check what it is. So now tell me what is the answer.
In the options, is it lambda k minus lambda
c? Yeah, minus.
Is it 2?
Check it. Okay, that's it. Should we discuss now? So when you increase the accelerating voltage, what happens to the electron which is coming from outside? It will have more kinetic energy. So you have more available energy to create a photon. So minimum possible wavelength or the maximum possible frequency will come when entire kinetic energy gets converted into photon. So if energy increases, lambda c will decrease. Lambda k anyway doesn't depend on accelerating electron. Lambda k will be fixed. Lambda c will decrease. So lambda k minus lambda c will increase. So option 1. Okay. You want to eat, you can have it. It is what?
I'll wait for break.
No, but you will not be able to. Your entire mind is there, okay. My food has come. Anybody else's food coming? So her parent loves the most. Okay, so she cooks like the fresh food, like everybody else will bring in the morning, but your mom will like every hour one packet should go.
No, not every hour.
Then? Centum lunch. Is that what you call it? Centum lunch. Why centum lunch is not. Your mom will hate when there is a centum, this thing. She has to cook more, right? So you'll be like negotiating, ma'am, today in centum lunch I want something like that, right? That's what you're checking, right? Whether it is there or not. She was very kind to take the food and give it to you. You know why? Okay, what is the answer? Don't talk nonsense. Okay. It has two distinct species. Having equal number of atoms initially, mean life of one species is tau, other one is 5 tau.
How will the formula change to different species?
The decay product in both cases are stable, means it doesn't disintegrate further. The plot is made of the total number of radioactive nucleus as a function of time. Okay. Now, as the time increases, we need to find the number of radioactive nuclei. As in how many are left.
So, yeah.
Will it decrease with time?
Yeah.
Will it remain constant?
No.
Will it ever increase?
No.
So option 4.
Yeah.
Right? Here see, suddenly it starts increasing. Here it did and there it remains constant. Okay? So if you really want to think too much, they'll give you reasons to think, but you'll be thinking in a wrong direction. So if you keep things simple, you'll get the answer. 42. Okay, for the third, what is asked? Number of electrons striking the target. Whatever electrons are striking the target, the current is because of them only.
Yeah.
Okay, so 3.2 milliampere, which is this much ampere, it should be a charge of electron, which is 1.6 into 10 to minus 19 into number of electrons striking per second. Fine. So from here you get the answer and you can look at it. The difference is in 10 to the power. So you can just find out what is 10 raised to the power this thing. It should be 10 to the power 16, right? So and anyway, straightforward. This is 2 and then 2 into 10 to the power 16. Okay. 44th.
Second one.
Angular momentum does not depend on the atomic number, right? Right? It is NH by 2 pi. So angular momentum should be same. But energy depends, right? But here mod of energy is compared.
Yeah,
you're getting it? Still. So 13.6 by n square into z square. This is mod of energy. This will be more than 13.6 by n square. If you just talk about the absolute value. But if you just talk about total energy, then actually it is less. Because it is more negative. But since you have taken mod, energy of the lithium will be more. At the mod of that. That's why option 2. See how they trick you. Like if you are in a hurry, like, oh, okay, fine, let me tick 3 and move on. Minus 1. From plus 4, you get minus 1. So 5 marks difference. Okay, we'll move to the next one. Start doing it if you are able to read. Forty-six. What if I is? One 16th means what? The activity is going down by 1/16, and activity depends on how many radioactive nuclei are there, right? So if activity is n, sorry, activity is proportional to number of nuclei, right? So if activity has to become half, n naught should become n naught by 2, then if activity has to go to half, it will be like this. So like that, you can see that. Now, how many times it becomes half? 1, 2, 3, 4 times. Right? So 4 half-lives it will take. Okay? So 100 into 4. 400. 46th.
Okay.
3.
Gamma is EM wave at neither atomic number nor mass number. Now tell me one thing, this nucleus, okay, this one is one nucleus, they are the same, they are the same nucleus, are their masses same? Why? Right, so you should write it like this, X star, this is at higher energy. Even though it is exactly same number of protons, neutrons and electrons, but then mass of that is slightly more than the ground state mass. So that is why you will see a term like rest energy or something like that. Okay? Because if it has a kinetic energy or it has an energy, its mass will be different. Okay? So be mindful of the fact that the difference, the mass defect is equal to energy of the gamma ray here. Fine. So H mu is equal to delta M C square. Okay. It will be very, very small. But even the small will create a lot of energy. Small defect. Electron, joule is of course much bigger than electron volts, but then you have to also understand that electron volts we use for typically electrons energy or nucleus energy. Now I'm saying one electron's energy is 2 electron volt, okay, and how many electrons will be there, suppose for example this bottle, there are like so many, right, it is more than 10 power 30, 40. So just multiply with that, it becomes huge. Okay. Now, typically in nuclear reaction, we're talking about mega electron volt. 10 raised to the power 6 times more energy. So because the multiplication factor is huge, even though electron volt is a very less energy, but electron itself is a very, very small, and there will be so many electrons will be there. Fine. So ultimately, when you multiply, it becomes tremendous amount of energy. You know this formula, R naught n square by
z
square.
No,
z. I remember it, z. Yeah, it is z. Same chapter is there in chemistry also, structure of atom. All of you. Bose radius is what? Radius of hydrogen atom's electron, which is at n equal to 1, which is R naught only. Last orbit is what? For this element, what is the last orbit?
N.
What is n equals to?
That's what. You get n square in the LHS and n in the RHS.
No.
Why?
This n is principal quantum number. It says that atom follows a Bohr's model and the radius of the last orbit of this is n times. Let's make it x. Okay, it is x times. Then what is the value of x? You are confusing between n here and principal quantum numbers. Now tell me, what is the value of last orbit's principal quantum number for this element?
VFR?
Tell me, what is the principal quantum number of last orbit? Do you know you can write it like this, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, like that you keep on writing, this number represent principal quantum number. So what is that for atomic number 100, what it should be? What is this called? What, when you write 1s2, 2s2 like that? Electronic configuration. Which electronic configuration? Is there any specific?
6. 6.
This is 7. Max will go to 7. So you can write like this. Dawn 5F12 7S2. I mean, it's a knowledge based thing actually. Nobody will be going up to this level of thing. Anyways, so 7 is the outermost principal quantum number, right? So this becomes 7 square divided by what is the atomic number? 100. So this is 49 by 100. So roughly it is 2. Are you sure it is Z, not Z square?
No, it's Z.
I think you have to assume it.
I'll come back to this. There is some confusion in the wordings of the question. So let's leave it. What about 48? Why? Density should be constant. If density is constant, then mass by volume should be constant. So mass should be proportional to volume. Okay. This is 49. 50.
So what's the TPY?
Heat.
C square in terms of electron volt is 957.
How about
C square in terms of is 957. It's close to that.
So. I don't know what you're saying.
No, no. Binding energy formula. Delta, it is definitely equal to delta.
1 AMU correspond to 931 MeV.
Okay.
Close to that.
So, 50th question.
I understood. 49 crore. Do both of them, then tell me the answer. 50th, all of you getting 4th?
Yes, sir.
50th is the easier one. I mean, calculation wise. You should do that first. Disintegration per second is DPS, not the so rate is proportional to number of nuclei. Should I do it? 50th? So let's say X DPS is at T equal to 0. Okay? After 280 days. After 280 days, it goes down to 6000 DPS, and then after 140 days, it drops to 3000. So what we can infer from here? Half-life is 140. Half-life is 140. Okay. So it was anyway two half-life away, 6000. Getting it? So 6000 should be X divided by 2 raised to power 2. See, 6000 is 2 half life away from X. It becomes half 2 times. So that is a X by 2 would be 140. Again by 2 in next 140. This is 6000. Okay. So the value of initial disintegration rate is 24,000. Forty-nine. What is the answer?
Is it four?
Guessing it?
No, really close.
How you're doing it?
He was binding in delta is equal to delta m into c square.
So delta m kaha hai yahan pe? There is no delta.
It's alpha particle, so mass has to reduce by.
हाँ ठीक है चल. What else?
So delta m will be 4 atomic masses.
No. It's not that alpha got directly converted to energy.
Okay.
Should I do it? So I'll first give you a hint. Suppose this is A. This is a nucleus. A is generally the mass number, right? So I'll take it X. So we have X whose mass number is 220. It decays into alpha particle, which is helium 4-2, plus another particle will be there, let's say Y, right? Here what should be the mass number?
216.
This is a reaction and heat released, Q. This is the heat. Now tell me, what is this heat? Heat is the kinetic energy of the atoms only, right? So 5.5 MeV is kinetic energy of helium plus kinetic energy of Y. Any doubt here?
No.
Okay. What else can I do here? What else? Bhai, this was at rest, na? Momentum will be conserved. Momentum of helium should be equal to momentum of Y. Okay? So kinetic energy of helium, let's say momentum is P. So I can use P for both because they are same. So I will take a pause here, solve it yourself.
4.
Kinetic energy of helium is p square divided by 2 times mass of helium, right? And kinetic energy of y is p square by 2 times mass of y. Getting it? So kinetic energy of helium divided by kinetic energy of y, how much will it come? Mass of y divided by mass of he. Mass of y is 216. Mass of helium is 4, right? So this is 54, right? So K helium is 54 times KY, okay? So just substitute there, you'll get 55 times KY is equal to 5.5, okay? So kinetic energy of Y is 0.1 MeV. Alright, so if kinetic energy of Y is 0.1 MeV, kinetic energy of helium is 54 into 0.1, which is 5.4 MeV, option 2, okay, right, any doubts?